I forgot to record my camera, so enjoy a faceless video, sorry. Check this out, I got this song in here. I'm almost ready to render, but I wanna make sure that my levels are correct. I'm gonna open the render dialog and click on dry run, no output. I just wanna see my waveforms. And what is this? It's a new feature. It's so cool. Now you're able to see, have this preview of all of your waveforms with the timeline. You can see the peak level, the LUFS levels. Not only that, you're able to see where you peak exactly with this little red line in here. Now you may notice that you can click and your edit cursor is gonna move to that position, but you're gonna try to play and it doesn't play. All you need to do is just right click and reopen this window to allow focus to return to project. So clicking on this, now you're able to control your project while this is still open and still useful because you can click on it, but now you got the ability to play it. So for example, let's go to this position where we peaked really hard and zoom into my project, and no wonder we peaked because this thing is super loud, so that was just for demonstration. Now I'm gonna run it again with the shortcut, because of course you can put a shortcut on this and makes it super fast. And yeah, my peak levels look fine, and not only that, you still have this super amazing and useful window where you can see with more details exactly your levels at any point of the song. To give you a more realistic scenario, I got this mastering project and I got all of the masters in here, and then I usually do a dry run to see where my level's at. So I'm gonna run the shortcut, which by the way, the shortcut you can find in the actions menu by searching for dry run, and there's all these shortcuts that you can set. I usually like to use this one within time selection, so I can just make a quick time selection, run the shortcut, and it's just gonna tell me the results in here. One thing I really enjoy is that you're still able to see the regions and on the markers in here. So I got the song names all in here, and it's just such a good visual. So these are my levels. And it's of course even more useful if you open the render statistics. Now let's go to another example. Let's say that you have a bunch of sound effects that you wanna render and you wanna quickly check your levels. I'm gonna run the shortcut for dry run, and things are looking good, but ooh, I got a few of them that are clipping. This is no problem because now I can simply select this and make my markers by placing the cursor in here, pressing M to drop a marker in there, and pressing M, pressing M, and pressing M, pressing M. Another useful thing is that you can right click and choose between momentary or short term loudness. And if I'm happy with this, I can just select render one file and it's just gonna actually render to my disk. Now, when you actually render, you still have all of the useful information. And you have a few more options in here. You can either add the file back to the project, or launch the file and all the regular options. So if you add file to project, it's just gonna make a new track and put it right in your project. Very, very useful. Now, another very welcome addition is all the new features they added to the metronome. Now, when you right click the metronome, you have all of these new options for really customizing your metronome sounds and how it's gonna play in your session. And right away, you have this super intuitive visual of how your metronome is gonna play. So this row of A, B, C, D, they are these samples that you have in here. So the accent note and the regular note. So for example, you have the accent in here and then the regular sounds in here. So ta, 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 ta. And you can of course just move it to another sample. Let's say that you have three sounds in here. It's gonna play those three sounds and then go back to B. The new thing is that you can choose a pattern of two or a pattern of four. So you have four different sounds for each bar. So bar one, bar two, bar three, and bar four. So for example, let's say that I have two different patterns. The one is gonna have two different accents like ta, to, ta, to, and then the one is gonna go ta, to, 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 and you can even go four, and by default they're gonna repeat. So for example, for the third round, I want a space in here and I want a space in here. So very cool, you can get so many kind of rhythms in here. And if you click this little plus, you can choose in between triplets, and that's gonna sound like this. Very cool, and you can choose the grid to follow this pattern. So if you enable this box, now your grid is gonna follow exactly this pattern. You can see the triplets are in here. That's just so useful for beat making or drum programming. Now onto the actual new feature is that you can have these sample presets in here to easily switch in between whatever samples or frequencies that you're choosing here. So I usually use this marimba sound. I really like it, but sometimes I want to use another one, and it's so simple. All I need to do is just find the new ones that I want to use. So for example, I like the Logic metronome, set no one ever, I don't like that one. And after adding that, we can just simply hit this, save preset and call it Logic. And let's add another one, maybe we like the Cubase, and save. So now the magic is that I can easily go to the marimba sound anytime. And if I wanna change it really fast, just go to the Cubase one, or go to the Logic one. Very, and that's it, I think. I mean, there's a lot of changes in here and I'm probably missing something cool, but let's just wait for Reaper Blocks video on this. Don't forget to check out the essential icons I made for Reaper. It's a huge collection of toolbar icons and track icons that I'm sure you're gonna love. I'm very proud of them, and I'm running a sale that is ending soon, so you can check out in the description. And yes, I love setting all of these lights and stuff and not filming the video for the tutorial. Oh well, I hope you enjoyed that video and I'll see you next time. Bye bye.